Watchers 10.
So what is that? And they told me that's the fairy. We've talked to various people about, you know, John in Revelation describing locusts that have wings. And I have pictures of creatures that look exactly like that. And if you look back to John's time during Revelation with his limited use of language, it's very uncanny that that's, to me, what he's describing. And these creatures are here now.
Mexico City. Traffic is heavy, and the idea of drug cartels is in the back of everybody's mind. There's extra security in all the expensive hotels in the area. And yet life goes on. Jaime Maussan is the host of the longest-running and most popular UFO television show in the world. He has millions of viewers, and people everywhere send him their videos. Sometimes that includes physical objects like spheres from space, or weird creatures. He records programs here, but we never expected to see something as unexplainable as what Jaime showed us this time. We were held to a promise that we wouldn't show this discovery until he granted us permission. To honor that agreement, we've sat on that finding for over 2 years. Now we're allowed to finally release it.
Ricardo, these creatures are very, very strange. Yeah. They're anomalous. I don't know really what I'm looking at, but you have done DNA testing on this creature and this creature. Tell us what you found.
This DNA sequence, was made from 5 different molecular biology laboratories in several parts of the world. And the common results has the DNA is very similar to DNA from humans, in 98.5% of similitudes. It's very strange.
The Metepec creature is a hybrid. The other creature that I show you is a hybrid. And that's something very important, because I believe they are experiments. What kind of experiments? Why? I don't know. But we have a physical body, and we can analyze that physical body and prove that something, an intelligence, is behind these experiments.
Do you think the phenomena is good or bad or both? You think it's a little mixture of both, or is it all good or all evil? What do you think?
I don't think it's good or evil. I think they have their own interest. I think they are not interfering with us, at least not massive. They are probably taking some people, some analyzing. I think they are doing their own experiments for their own agenda.
The legs, the feet.
Okay.
But this creature have another. It's the wings. We have an X-ray of this creature.
You have an X-ray of it?
Yes, we have an X-ray.
What did the X-ray show?
And we can see the structure of the bones. With the structure.
So this is not a hoax?
No.
It is not a hoax?
Not a hoax.
Because an X-ray would show that it was a puppet or a mold?
No. This is a model. And we have a sample of tissues of this creature, and we sent to DNA molecular laboratory. But when the laboratory tried to sequencing this DNA, not found a concordance with DNA from the mammals or other creatures.
So both the mitochondrial DNA and the nuclear DNA, no matches at all?
No match with
no
any
matches.
Creature
wow.
Related with the mammals.
Thank you, Ricardo. Thank you so much for coming on the camera. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Ricardo was kind enough to take some DNA samples for us, which were put into a sterile container. These samples would have been tested in the USA at a DNA lab, but they were confiscated by the TSA upon entering America and destroyed. This was after confirming permissions by phone at the airport with Jaime Maussan. Since the TSA confiscated samples given to watchers of the ferry 3 years ago, we were unable to test it until recently.
Para mandárselos al investigador J. Marzulli, para...
Jaime had Ricardo take new samples. They were flown in from Mexico in 2016 and arrived safely this time. The new samples were tested by two DNA labs. However, since the ferry had been immersed in formaldehyde for several years, none of the labs were able to derive any DNA from it. Since there are hoaxes of ferries on the internet that we knew of, we needed to make sure that this creature was real. We needed to see the X-rays. Perhaps that would give us some fresh clues. At a rare dinner in Beverly Hills with Jaime, he told us the whole story of how he got the ferry.
Is there any possibility in your mind that it might be a hoax?
No. There is no possibility because the man who found it is a 13-year-old who didn't know what it was, who didn't ask anything for it, and didn't have any kind of knowledge about extraterrestrials, fairies, or anything else.
Nothing like that.
He just saw an opportunity. He wanted to know at the beginning what it was, and then afterwards, probably to get one penny or two. But nothing more than that. I mean, to consider that this young kid would have the knowledge to do something scientific like this.
Sophisticated.
To create something like this is absolutely impossible.
Mm-hmm.
I would change my name if he did something else.
Right. Jaime, where did this 13-year-old boy, where did he find this creature?
He found it on the side of the highway. He was traveling from Guadalajara to Mexico. He stopped very near to the exit to Morelia, but on the highway. He was doing his physical necessities on the side of the highway, and he saw it. And he told me that it was clear that was very recently dead. I mean, it didn't have passed more time, a lot of time between that moment and the time of the death of this creature. He thought probably a few minutes before he found it. But I didn't do this to make money or to explode this because I haven't done it.
I know you have.
Now I want your help.
And that's what we're going to do.
To do a scientific research, I don't want to tell anybody that this is the real thing or something extraordinary. When I don't know, we need the DNA, we need more analysis on this, and if we can do it through you, I'm willing to do it.
There were two X-rays, a front and profile view. They show a complete skeletal structure. There was a break in the ferry's left leg that looked like it had been repaired at one time. The skull of the creature was detailed. The hands and tiny fingers appeared in the X-ray as Ricardo had described. The actual head of the ferry had pointy ears, like Spock, or like what you would find on a gargoyle. But there were several white dots that seemed to not have anything to do with the ferry, but may have been added later. We didn't know what these dots were. There's always the assumption that someone made the creature by gluing it together from parts from other creatures. But the asymmetrical placement of the dots was troubling. They didn't seem to have any reason for being there. The X-rays proved fascinating. So LA showed them to a veterinarian. We weren't allowed to state his name or show his face, but we could record the conversation. What he came up with stunned us.